Today on Florida Sportsman Best Boat. If you're finally ready to venture outside of the inlet, we'll be taking a look at the Sea Born LX21, a center console with an overall length of 20 feet 6 inches, a beam of 8 feet 6 inches, and max horsepower rating of 200. Standout features on the Sea Born LX21. With the capability to fish offshore, having a sharp hull entry at the bow will ensure a smooth ride in choppy or rough conditions. Perfect for bringing the family, bow seating with removable backrests allow passengers to face forward and enjoy the view while underway. With the majority of the time spent at the helm, a well-designed console layout will be appreciated. The boat captain should be able to both sit and stand to drive comfortably. For those who have decided that most of their adventures will take them offshore, but don't want to leave the family behind, we'll be looking at the Sea Fox 266 Commander, a center console with an overall length of 26 feet, a beam of 9 feet 3 inches, and max horsepower rating of 400. Standout features on the Sea Fox 266 Commander. Designed for a plethora of activities on the water, a large storage compartment will hold all the gear you need to bring, fishing tackle, dive tanks, and more. Whether cruising or hanging at the sandbar, lounge-style bow seating will provide everyone on the boat with a comfortable place to kick back and relax. To maximize cockpit space, a simple leaning post for helm seating is more than adequate and allows for cooler storage underneath. If you're serious about fishing in blue water and want to be the first at the bait stop, we'll be taking a look at the Contender 35ST, a center console with an overall length of 34 feet 10 inches, a beam of 10 feet, and max horsepower rating of 1,050. Standout features on the Contender 35ST. Built for the offshore tournament circuit, a stepped hull provides a more efficient ride, allowing for more range and speed using less horsepower. For anglers serious about offshore fishing, a built-in rigging station is a perfect place to prepare your baits and lures so you're ready for when the bite gets hot. A well-engineered live well system will keep baits alive and kicking throughout the entire day of fishing, even in the roughest of conditions. Join our hosts Dave East and Rick Riles as they conduct walkthroughs and review key features, all to help you decide if this is the best boat for you.
Welcome to this episode of Florida Sportsman Best Boat. I'm your host Dave East, along with my co-host Captain Rick Riles. We're going to look at three center consoles today. And although the boats are a little bit similar in mission, they're definitely different in length.
I tell you, that 21 Seaborn is a fine offshore boat in the right conditions. I can't wait to get on that one and look it over thoroughly because, boy, that's how I grew up, was on a 21-foot center console.
Well, it's where everybody gets started. You know, that size boat is really where people get their first taste of offshore fishing. Single engine, you can pull it with a small vehicle, and it's a size to learn on.
It is, and if you get the fever, if you get hooked and you've got that 3 feet bigger fever, 26 is a great stop for your next stop.
Well, sure it is. This Sea Fox 26, now if you want to take four or five buddies, twin power is available, you can obviously go further offshore. Yeah, you're going to burn more fuel, but the boat's more capable. So as your experience grows, obviously so is the length of your boat, so your next stop up from 21 feet might be 26.
And unfortunately, my boy, that's not where it ends, okay?
Not even close.
You get that 3 foot itis, here you go, now you're committed. You want to be in the tournament scene, you want to chase the biggest fish around, you want to carry a zillion live baits, that 35 Contender opens up a whole new world to you.
And what I like about a center console in a 35 foot range is, you know, it's just as capable as the sport fish behind us, but a lot less expensive to run. And I'm gonna get to the grounds faster, I'm gonna burn less fuel, I'm gonna have more fun doing it, and it's not gonna cost me near what that battle wagon is.
And let me tell you something, one of the things I love about fishermen, there's always fish just a little bit further, okay? Well, in a 35, like this Contender, there's almost no place you can't go.
When we come back, hosts Dave East and Rick Riles take a closer look at a boat made for those who are ready to begin venturing outside of the inlet, the Sea Born LX21. This segment brought to you by MyFWC. Life jackets save lives.
Dads are great. They keep us safe. They teach us all kinds of stuff and do fun things with us. They can be really funny. I think about my dad a lot. I miss him. I wish he had thought about me and worn his life jacket.
Welcome back to Florida Sportsman Best Boat. Join our hosts Dave East and Rick Riles as they take a closer look at the Sea Born LX21. Representing the 15 to 23 foot class in the center console category, the Sea Born LX21 has an overall length of 20 feet 6 inches, a beam of 8 feet 6 inches, and a max horsepower rating of 200. Designed for a big boat feel in a small boat package, she has a draft of 13 inches, a dead rise of 18 degrees, a dry weight of 2,100 pounds, and a fuel capacity of 68 gallons. Now, let's hear more from our hosts, Dave East and Rick Riles.
We're aboard the Sea Born LX21, and this is the smallest boat in their LX family of center consoles, but it certainly doesn't ride like a small boat. It's got a sharp V entry, and with that big bow flare, this boat can hold its own in that rough stuff offshore.
You saw that for yourself this
morning.
Absolutely, you know what this boat is? I got it for this boat.
What's that?
This boat's fun, David. Okay, it has gorgeous yacht-like lines. It doesn't look like a 21-foot boat. It looks like a shorter 35-foot boat, and it's just plain fun.
The boat is just put together where it's really not a large center console, but it's much larger than a bay boat. So if you're looking for that boat to kind of fill in the size, maybe a bay boat's too small, but you're not really ready to step up into a large center console, this might be the right size 21.
You're plenty big enough to where if you go offshore on a nice day, it's plenty of boat. Now, I'm not gonna go offshore on this boat on a rough day, but heck, I don't wanna go offshore on a rough day anyway.
No, no. Any 21-foot boat that you can't take offshore, you're gonna stay inside. Problem is, when you get to a bigger center console boat, they don't do very well inside. You get them in the bays and you get them in the flats, they're just too big. This boat, you don't have that problem with. Well, starting up here at the bow, you can talk about the inside of the boat. I wanna talk about what's underneath. This boat has a really nice sharp entry, but it's got a lot of bow flare. And you saw when we went out that inlet this morning, this boat throws the water to the side. It stayed nice and dry. Never once did I have any fear of stuffing the bow because of the flare just won't allow it to happen.
Buddy, I gotta tell you, it looked like deadliest catch with you rolling out of that inlet this morning. That was really special watching it break all the way across the inlet, but the boat ate it up. I understand how impressed you are with the underside of the boat, but you know what? They put a lot of function into this bow. Sure, it's a very nice place to sit, very nice place to lay back, but all you gotta do is pop these headrests, pop these cushions, two insulated fish boxes under here. It'd take both of them to hold my catch. Yours, maybe not so much. But you can store life jackets and stuff on one side and do your fishing the other. They maximize their space up here.
You have additional seating here in the front of the console. This is also insulated. We used it as a cooler today, but this can also be plumbed as a live well. So you have the ability to put three live wells on this boat if you want. So in other words, if you're fishing off of the bow, you can get your bait here. You don't have to run all the way to the back. So it's everything that you would need up here without being too much. As we move back to the console, there's something I want to talk about here, because the way they've designed this console is something that we don't see on a lot of boats that we've tested in Best Boat. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Okay, this is what I'm talking about with the ergonomics of this console. And this is not an understatement. This is something that's really hard for a boat builder to achieve. What he has done, he's got a console design that you can sit and you can stand, and it's comfortable either way. Your line of sight is good. It's like sitting in your car. And here again, if this is where you're gonna spend a lot of time when you're behind the helm in a boat, when you're operating your boat, what, 80% of your time is gonna be right here behind that steering wheel?
Mm-hmm.
It's got to fit you.
Well, you're right. And this one fits me very nice standing up. And it also, because of this footrest for me is in a perfect location. I've still got my line of sight over the bow, and I'm very, very comfortable.
Well, let's look here in the back of the cockpit, because I like the way they've expanded their transom bulkhead. You've got twin built-in jump seats and a center-mounted live well.
And you've got another live well under here, and you can plumb a live well up front. Dave, I love what they did with this transom bulkhead. There's no need for a walk-through door or anything. It's the right height, very easy for a diver to get on there and just step over, and yet you're not worried about the ocean coming in on you. This is a wonderful use of space.
Well, you've got an integrated built-in bracket as well, so if you do want to step back there, if you're going to be diving, if you're going to be snorkeling, heck, if you're going to land a big fish, you can easily get over this bulkhead and you can step back there. And look at the power. Single engine, plenty. They have a 200. This boat does not need a 200. With a 150, this would be a screamer. It's very economical to operate, to purchase, and to maintain.
If I had to come up with one word for the Sea Born 2150, it would be fun.
Fun's good. Mine would be function. Put those two together, and you've described this 21-foot boat perfectly.
When we return, hosts Dave East and Rick Riles step aboard a boat designed for family fun and fishing offshore, the Sea Fox 266 Commander. This segment brought to you by Oceanic Gear. Wear the gear, catch the fish.
Whether you are offshore trolling or running the flats, Oceanic Gear is setting a new standard in performance fishing apparel. Our clothing has unmatched comfort, all-day sun protection, uncompromising durability, all at a price you can afford. We bring a unique look and feel to the game with vivid, colorful design. Whatever the species, whatever your style, we've got you covered. Oceanic Gear. Wear the gear, catch the fish.
Welcome back to Florida Sportsman Best Boat. Join our hosts Dave East and Rick Riles as they step aboard the Sea Fox 266 Commander. Representing the 26 to 27 foot class in the center console category, the Sea Fox 266 Commander has an overall length of 26 feet, a beam of 9 feet 3 inches, and a max horsepower rating of 400. Built with offshore fishing as the priority, she has a draft of 16 inches, a dead rise of 20 degrees, a dry weight of 4,200 pounds, and a fuel capacity of 143 gallons. Now, let's hear more from our hosts, Dave East and Rick Riles.
This is the Sea Fox 266 Commander, and if your activities on the water call for the need of several different boats, but you've only got the budget for one, this boat might be the perfect boat you're looking for. But what they've done is they've addressed the need and the function of several things. If you're a diver, this boat will fit the bill. If you're a fisherman, if you want to take the family out, if you want to cruise, they've allowed this boat to do a lot of things, but yet keep it in a manageable size for your driveway, for your budget.
And for your tow vehicle, don't forget that too. You don't need a dually to pull it. You mentioned storage and you mentioned a diver. Check this out. You know who designed this? A diver.
Well, that's easy to see because you can store all your dive gear in there, but more importantly, it's got a place to store your dive tanks to keep them from rattling or falling over. And that's important because spearfishing, free diving, that stuff has gotten huge over the last few years. But very few manufacturers actually focus on the dive community. What they've done here, they've gone a step further and they've used this storage area for anything. Yeah, you can put fish and ice in there, but they've also made it applicable for just about anything you're gonna do on this boat.
There is no more comfortable place to sit ahead of the transom of the boat than right here.
There is one more place that's more comfortable to sit, and that's the bow seating up here. And to call it seating is really not adequate. These are more lounges than they are seats. It's like sitting in your Lazy Boy. You can face aft, these people facing forward, you can have a conversation. But if more people want to face forward, you've got your backrest that swing out, and now you can if you want to. As you go aft, look at the legs on this T-top. All of their welding is done in-house. And to find something powder coated this color is one thing, but just the size and the build of it just speaks to the quality of the overall build on this boat.
We see more and more hard tops all the time, and that really is the way to go. Now the hard tops are storage spaces, they get you out of the weather, they're just a much better way to get you shade while you're on the water.
The design of the console, not only with the T-top around it, but the console itself fits the boat. On my side, I've got built-in tackle storage. On your side, you've got a door that leads into a console with plenty of room for a potty.
Full-size entrance, put stuff, big stuff in here, get in here yourself to get out of the weather if you have to. Comes back to a very well thought out console. Great line of sight. I can see all the way past the bow very easily. Makes it so much easier to dock, makes it so much less dangerous when I'm throttling up and I've got that little blind spot. You are always able to see what's directly ahead of you. But you know what, I like this. I haven't seen this before. This comes straight from the automotive world. Doesn't that look like the center console on a really nice car?
Well, it does, and it puts all your gauges where you can see them. Your switches are easy to get to. You still got plenty of room for your flush mount electronic. You've got your padded dash up here that you like for throwing your cell phone or throwing your fishing pliers and stuff like that. The design of the seat, it fits the design of the T-top. They've really done some things I like. They use a great big 4-inch down tube. They've eliminated the back legs, so it frees up a lot more room in your cockpit. You have a cooler underneath. Nothing looks like it's added onto this boat. Everything looks like it's been engineered to purposely be put on this
boat. There's no afterthoughts.
Step behind here. I'm going to show another thing as a fisherman you're really going to like. Another advantage of them doing all their aluminum work in-house, look how they have laid out their rod holders on the T-top. And it comes standard with the Kingfish rod holders on the side. Great design. This is aluminum work that you just don't normally see. They do it in-house to match the boat.
Anytime you do things in-house, everything, the whole boat speaks of the brand that it is. You understand what I'm saying?
One of the things that really sets a boat apart in my eyes is the way they've done these jump seats. This is the first time I've seen jump seats like this in a big 26-foot center console.
This makes a perfect transom door until you flip it up and it's a jump seat. You've actually got two different functions in one in the same place.
Another family feature they've added, they got a tow bit. You're gonna pull a water toy behind the boat. It's so much better to pull it from an elevated position than it tries to do it from a cleat or a stern eye. And if you're gonna fish out of the boat, here's your nice big oval live well that you like to see.
Oh, I do. The bigger, the better. And when the bait has got a long distance to swim and no corners to get trapped in, it lives a whole lot longer.
Well, there's a lot of features that are packed into this 26-foot boat. Easy to trailer, you only need a pair of 150s to push it. So this is a boat that'll fit into your budget. You can get offshore with it, you can take the family. This boat will do a lot of things that the bigger center consoles will do, but in a more manageable size.
When we come back, hosts Dave East and Rick Riles check out a boat built for the most dedicated of blue water anglers, the Contender 35ST. This segment brought to you by Suzuki Marine, the ultimate four-stroke outboard. Welcome back to Florida Sportsman Best Boat. Join our hosts Dave East and Rick Riles as they check out the Contender 35ST. Representing the 31 to 53 foot class in the center console category, the Contender 35ST has an overall length of 34 feet 10 inches, a beam of 10 feet, and a max horsepower rating of 1,050. Built for fishing offshore in even the roughest of conditions, she has a draft of 21 inches, a dead rise of 24.5 degrees, a dry weight of 6,600 pounds, and a fuel capacity of 400 gallons. Now, let's hear more from our hosts, Dave East and Rick Riles.
You know, we cover a lot of boats in Best Boat that are for fishing and family, but we haven't forgot about you tournament guys. This is the Contender 35ST, and it is all about showing up at the winner's circle.
Oh, is it? Now, let me tell you something. Center console boats, and actually Contenders in particular, have taken the South Florida sailfish scene by storm. There's no big money tournaments down there anymore that you don't see them in the weigh-in line. There's a lot of reasons for it. Not only the Contender hull and the great running surface, the two steps, everything about this boat screams tournament fishing.
Well, let's not get away from that stepped hull too quick, because what the stepped hull does, this boat compared to a typical V-hull boat, talking about 20% more efficiency. Every time that hull steps up, it induces air. You get air, the bubbles get sucked into the bottom of the hull, and you break that wetted surface. Less friction, more efficiency. It's a really simple design. It's been around for a long time. You can get a lot more range out of the boat with the same horsepower.
They're built to get there first when the money's on the line. That's why the steps are so important for a tournament-style boat.
Okay, let's look at the inside of the way this boat's laid out now. For the tournament fisherman, you start with a cockpit and a nice flat deck. Tell me the importance of that.
Your best competitive teams know that you can't get your bites one at a time. Their job is to turn one bite into four or five. You understand what I'm saying? That means a fish on in the back of the boat, you've got to find the rest of the fish, and you've got to be able to get up here and get up here in a hurry. That's why that flat deck's so important. There's nothing to climb up on. There's no step. There's nothing. There's just go.
You've got plenty of storage below that deck, too. You've got built-in fish boxes down in the floor. They're insulated, but you've got a lot of room to take all of your gear.
Speaking of storage, let me show you my favorite idea ever for a center console. I am a huge fan of a center console box like this. My daughter grew up sleeping on a coffin box every day just like this while we were fishing.
Well, it's storage, it's insulated cooler for a big fish or for taking all your drinks, but there's another one below it. Now, you're not gonna lift this thing up when it's full. There's an actuator. You hit a switch on the console, this whole thing tilts up on an actuator. Now you can get to the stuff that's stored below it without having to unload this. The face of the console, it's got room for electronics. They're all flush mounted, but lift up on that latch. The fact that they're hidden behind this door, you know, you're gonna get a lot of glare when you're on the water. I know you've got the T-top on here, But that little bit to push those electronics back that far makes a huge difference in the fact that you can read all of your displays.
It makes everything different. You can read them from different angles because they're recessed. You know what else? They don't get salt on the face. And when they don't get salt on the face, they don't get scratched. Those screens will stay better longer, just recessed that little bit.
Well, you do have a side entry door that leads you down into the console. There's enough room for a head down there. And the interior of this console is absolutely gorgeous. They finished it out with teak. Just one more thing that Contender can do, make the boat a little bit more personal, but not lose that tournament edge.
Don't forget this seat, 3 abreast across here, very, very comfortably.
Well, it needs to be. Let's face it, a 35-foot boat like this, you're not fishing the river. A boat like this is gonna make some long runs. You've gotta be comfortable when you make a run like that, and you gotta be secure. This boat can take rough conditions. Having these sides like that, you're in the seat, you're not on it.
All right, you wanna talk about something that screams competitive fishing at you? Look at this. This is a custom Contender invention. It's a portable rigging table, okay? Just sets in 2 rod holders, rig your dredges, rig your ballyhoo, whatever you need to get done, you can do it right here.
You've got insulated fish boxes that are built into the boat, but you've also got a high-tech cooler that's on a slide.
But let me give you the last piece of the puzzle. This is one of the reasons we call this a tournament fishing machine, okay? Doesn't have a live well, has a live well system.
Each live well has its own 1,500 gallon per hour pump, and they're in a box. It's like a sea chest, we used to call it, you know, in the old days. But it brings the water in there. The pumps take the water from the chest and pump it out. It's a lot safer, and you only have one pickup in the bottom of the boat rather than having 3 separate sea strainers.
But yeah, the job is to keep your bait swimming so it doesn't get trapped in a corner and die. Think about 1,500 gallons an hour going through these.
Like, that's a
lot. You talk about your bait working hard. It's ready to go when you reach in and take it out of that tank.
35-foot boat, absolutely built for the tournament angler. It's got everything you need, clean, uncluttered deck. This is a boat that will take you into the winner's circle every time.
Man, I enjoyed today's episode. I grew up around center console boats, but they were a whole lot different than these. I didn't realize how much they'd evolved.
Well, they really have, but one thing's remained the same, the fact that size dictates where you're gonna use the boat. Smaller center console, that little Sea Born 21, we were able to take that boat in shallower water than you would normally take a center console.
Yes, but when we were ready to break the inlet and get into a little choppier sea, we were ready to step aboard the 26.
Well, I was glad we had that Sea Fox out there because, you know, it got a little rough and the boat took it well. But when we wanted to go really further offshore, it was exhilarating getting on that Contender.
It was. The bigger you get, the more possibilities you open. In that 35 Contender, your possibilities are almost endless.
For more information on the boats that you've seen in today's episode, or to see any of the boats we've tested this year in Best Boat, go to our website, floridasportsman.com.
Or we'll see you on next week's episode of Florida Sportsman Best Boat.
When filming for Florida Sportsman Best Boat, the cast and crew docked and dined at Fort Pierce City Marina in Fort Pierce, Florida, featuring a full-service, state-of-the-art dock system within walking distance from excellent restaurants and historic downtown Fort Pierce. Each month, turn to Florida Sportsman for the best in boating and fishing coverage.